Thank God we're out of there. Well, where's Floyd? I thought he was with you. Well, we're going to have to go back in there and get him. Are you crazy? We can't go back in there. It will get us. But we can't leave him in there. He's our friend, Keith. I can't just ditch a friend. I want to save him too, Cliff. But this is no job for us. We need to call the professionals. But it will probably be too late by the time they help us. Cliff, for once, just listen to me. We aren't the right people to save him. We'll have to call the police and tell them what happened. If we go in there ourselves and try to save Floyd, it will get us both. We can't tell the police that we're being here. They'll arrest us for trespassing. Either we risk our lives to save someone else's, or we put behind bars for God knows how long. I know a group that may help us. I'm positive they won't arrest us for trespassing. I hope you're right, Keith. Poor Floyd.
I think we've landed. This looks interesting.
Are you coming, you two?
No, Doctor. Zoe's feeling unwell. I better stay here to look after her.
Very well. I won't be long.
Where are you going?
I'm going out to get some fresh air. Now, don't you two go dawdling off while I'm gone. The forest is a very easy place to get lost.
We won't, Doctor.
Get well, Zoe.
Greyhound to Trap 1, Greyhound to Trap 1, do you read me? Over.
Trap 1 to Greyhound, we read you. Over.
Ah, Benton. Look, are you sure I've come to the right place?
Well, I assume so, sir. Cederworth isn't hard to miss.
Yes, well, I can't see the estate, Benton. It's pitch dark out here.
Well, those young boys who contacted us shouldn't be too far away, sir.
I hope you're right, Benton. This place makes me nervous.
I feel very sorry for you, sir. You're certainly very brave for going up there.
Be quiet for a second, Benton.
What is it, sir?
I think somebody might be here with me.
It might be those kids, sir.
I'll talk to you later, Benton. Greyhound out. Is someone there? Show yourself.
Ha ha! Brigadier!
Doctor, is that you?
Of course it's me, my old friend. How are you?
Oh, not too bad, Doctor. Yourself?
Oh, very well, thank you.
What brings you here to Farnborough?
Oh, just passing through the area while on our travels.
Oh, yes. How is young Jamie and Zoe?
Well, at the moment they're feeling a little bit under the weather, but they've been well. What brings you to, what's this place called?
Farnborough. Oh, just doing a routine checkup. Some young kids have been messing about an abandoned house in the area. One of their friends has reportedly gone missing.
Oh, that's not good at all now, is it?
Did they say how their friend went missing?
They didn't say exactly what happened. All they remembered was there was a loud beeping noise and the scream of their friend. Then they said they didn't recall anything else that happened since they were scared out of their skin. They ran away and they called us about the event.
Well, this all rather interests me. Am I allowed to come along?
I can't see why not, Doctor. You've helped me in the past. I'm sure you can help me again.
Excellent. Now then, how far away is this place?
This way, Doctor.
Where on earth could they be?
Hopefully they're not too far away.
You sure these people won't arrest us?
I'm positive, Cliff. Stop worrying about it.
Well, in case you've forgotten, Keith, our friend is missing, and God knows what has happened to him.
And you don't think I'm concerned for him? I care about Floyd as much as you do. I'm worried sick about him. Now just listen to me for once. These people are professionals, and they will not care about the fact that we were trespassing on private property. If they want to know our reasoning for coming here, we'll just tell them it is our job. So just calm down for once in your life.
Keith, look!
What?
There was something moving in the house. I could have sworn I saw a shadow of somebody.
I don't see anything. I think you're going paranoid, Cliff. You're imagining things.
Oh, I don't know anymore, Keith. Ever since the incident, I just can't think straight. I don't feel safe anymore. All that I can think of is about Floyd. What if we're too late, Keith?
I'm sure he's safe, Cliff. All you have to do is just believe that he's all right.
Hope you're right, Keith. Do you reckon that's them?
I hope so. Let's yell out to them. Hello?
We thought you'd never come.
Well, it took some time for us to find the way. I'm Brigadier Lefred Stewart, and this is my scientific advisor, the Doctor.
Nice to meet you two.
My name's Keith.
And I'm Cliff.
So give us a rundown of what happened to your friend.
Well, myself, Cliff, and Floyd, our friend that went missing, were exploring this abandoned mansion because we heard from the locals that this place was haunted. So when we entered the mansion, everything was going well. Until what? Until we heard Floyd scream. Something must have really scared him because we've never heard him scream like that before.
So what did you do afterwards?
We ran for our lives. I know it sounds terrible to run away and leave your friend behind in distress, but we had a sudden adrenaline rush and forgot all about him. To be honest, we were both worried about ourselves. We worried that we might be too late to save him.
I'm sure he's safe and sound.
You really think so?
I know so. If the doctor thinks he's all right, then he is right.
If you think he's all right, Doctor, what do you think has really happened to him?
I really don't know, to be honest with you. But I'm sure nothing has severely harmed him.
Let's hope.
One question I'd like to ask you two gentlemen. Why on earth were you messing about at this place? You do realize that it has been off the limits from the public.
We won't lie to you, Brigadier. We're ghost hunters.
Ghost hunters?
Yes, we've been doing it for quite some time now, and we still haven't encountered any sort of paranormal activity.
Until yesterday, it seems.
You seriously think a ghost attacked your friend?
Well, it must be. The locals have claimed that a ghost has inhabited this estate for a long time now, so how couldn't it be? It can't be aliens, surely.
I won't doubt it for a second, Cliff. The Doctor and I have dealt with many forms of extraterrestrial life. On all of those occasions, we have defeated them. Isn't that right, Doctor? The last invaders we dealt with was the Cybermen, wasn't it?
Ah, yes. The attempted invasion led by Mr. Demise Vaughn, no doubt. Yes, that was an eventful time.
Excuse me. None of this is relevant to the disappearance of our friend.
Yes, I apologize for that. The Doctor and I were just reminiscing about the last time we met.
So you generally think an alien is the one accountable for the disappearance of Floyd?
It's a possibility. One we shouldn't rule out for the time being.
Well, let's not waste the time we have.
Well, lead the way.
Well, would you look at that?
It looks huge. How do you suppose we're going to find him?
We know the way. A lot of the rooms have been cordoned off, so he can only be in a select portion of the mansion.
Oh, let's get this over and done with. This place makes me nervous.
Do you think it is too late, Doctor?
Hard to say, Brigadier. I doubt it is a ghost, but I have strong suspicions of it being some kind of alien life.
Why would an alien want to take refuge in an abandoned mansion and kidnap a human?
I want to know the answers to these questions as well. Perhaps they needed a physical body to do their dirty work, or maybe it was a way of luring me into some kind of trap.
What makes you think that, Doctor?
Oh, it has happened before, Brigadier. Numerous amounts of times, in fact.
Come along, you two.
We're on our way. Come along, Doctor. After you, Brigadier. Is the door unlocked?
It should be. The last time we were here, it was.
It seems seems we are expected. Come along.
Did anyone bring a torch?
Yes, here you go.
Now, that is strange. Did this happen to you before?
Certainly not. Didn't even know there were lights available in the mansion.
No, I can't deal with this. I must leave.
Well, we definitely are wanted here. Don't worry, Cliff. We'll take care of you.
But why are you so calm about all of this?
Well, somebody has to be. It's not very reassuring when the one you have hope in is secretly the one who is scared the most. Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
But don't you see? Where next?
Cliff's right, Doctor. I mean, they clearly are drawing us into some sort of trap.
But there is only one way in finding out that it is a trap, and that is to journey deeper into the spider's web.
Believe me, you two, when the Doctor knows what he is doing, he does know what he is doing.
Oh, thank you, Brigadier. Right then, shall we continue? Do you ever get that feeling that someone is watching you?
Yes, Doctor. Why? Are you getting that feeling right now?
I'm afraid so, Brigadier. Somebody has watched our every move since we have entered this mansion.
Yeah, I'm getting that feeling too, Doctor.
So do I.
Now that you mention it, I'm under that impression as well. But there isn't any sign of surveillance cameras. There is definitely somebody watching us with their very own eyes.
Hello? What are you doing, Doctor?
I want our little friend to come out and greet us. Come along now. Don't be shy.
Thank you.
You sure it's safe to go in there, Doctor?
Only one way in finding out. Did somebody turn on the torch?
Quickly, man. What's taking so long?
The batteries are flat.
Don't worry. I have one.
Floyd! Are you okay?
Floyd, are you deaf? You must obviously be in a state of shock. Here, let me help you.
I'm afraid I can't let you do that, Keith. I don't think your friend is really there.
What? Is he possessed or something?
It seems like it.
Well, there must be something that you can do, Doctor.
Well, what can I do? I've never dispossessed someone before. I would have to...
Silence!
Doctor, that voice.
Yes, Brigadier. I recognize it too.
You have not forgotten us, Doctor.
Well, how could I? You're one of my best enemies, are you not?
You are correct, Doctor. Too many times you have defeated us, but this current encounter shall be your last.
What have you done to Floyd?
Your friend is merely a puppet for our scheme. We are only using him to create our machinery and for us to communicate with you directly. Your friend is perfectly safe.
What are you? Where do you come from?
We are the Great Intelligence. We do not have a particular home planet. We simply float through space and time.
I have one question to ask you. How did you know I was coming here?
It was a lucky assumption that you were to arrive here. We created this kidnapping as a means of diverting you here.
So you'll use Floyd the same way you used Staff Arnold and Professor Travers, no doubt.
All of these memories are irrelevant. You may have defeated us in Tibet and in the underground stations, but we have grown in strength and we know your ways.
So what do you plan to do to me? Erase my memory again?
Your intelligence is valuable to us, and we wish to take it from you once again. But this time, the process will not only take your mind, but destroy you completely.
And what machinery have you created to enable this? Where's the glass pyramid you made before?
We have developed a device which doesn't require you to sit in it. We learned that you found a way to bypass it until your companion faltered your plans.
So what have you devised?
You are standing right in it.
I can't see it, I'm afraid. Could you maybe turn the lights on?
How did you do that?
The great intelligence communicate telepathically. I would imagine that they have some sort of influence on the lights.
You are correct once again, Doctor. This is why we need your intelligence.
So how do you drain my mind?
Like this. Goodbye, Doctor.
Shoot, Brigadier! Shoot the console!
No!
Quick, grab Floyd. The mansion is about to explode. We should get out of here as soon as possible. How long do you think we have, Doctor? Not long if we just stand here doing nothing. I'd say that's a cue for us to leave, immediately. Run! Is everyone all right?
I think so. What about Floyd?
Oh, he's fine. Just unconscious, that's all. He should be coming around soon.
Oh, where am I? Cliff? Keith? What happened to me?
It's a long story, Floyd. Something we can talk about over a nice cold beer at the tavern.
You probably won't believe us anyway.
I see. Well then, last one to the tavern has to pay the bill.
A thank you would have been nice. Well, I suppose I can thank you, Doctor. I can always rely on you.
Of course you can, Brigadier. At my pleasure.
Do you think that the intelligence will return?
Hard to say at this stage. There are plenty entities of the intelligence floating around in space. I wouldn't doubt a return from them for a second.
Well, so long as you're here to assist us, we should be alright. Anyway, suppose you better be off on your travels, hadn't you?
Yes, I'd better check on Zoe and Jamie. It was nice catching up with you, Alistair. I'm sure we'll meet each other again at the most unexpected of times.
I'm sure we will, Doctor. Take care. You too.
What would we do without you, Doctor?